Ladies and gentlemen, Simon and Garfunkel.
I may find her. It's really not a song about an imaginary girl, Emily. It's a song about a belief. And Overs, the song that follows Emily, is about the loss of that belief. Why don't we stop fooling ourselves? The game is over, over, over. No good times, no bad times. There's no times at all, just the New York Times. Sitting on the windowsill, near the flowers. We might as well be apart. It hardly matters, we sleep separately. And drop a smile passing in the hall. But there's no laughs left, 'cause we laughed them all. And we laughed them all in a very short time.
Time is tapping on my forehead, hanging from my mirror, rattling the teacups, and I wonder
how long can I delay. Just a habit like saccharin, and I'm habituated, feeling kind of blue. But each time I try on the thought of leaving you, I stop and think it over. I used to live in England, and I was in England, in fact, when The Sounds of Silence became a hit here in the United States. And while I was there, I became friendly with a blues guitarist named Davy Graham, who taught me a guitar piece called Angie that we'll do in a second. And, before I was in England, I was very friendly with my brother, who is seated over there, and will come on up and play it with me. It's my brother Ed.
You want to count off?
Sure, why not? We have the same mother.
Go. Thank you. falling leaves, casting shivering shadows on the houses through the trees. And the light from a street lamp paints a pattern on my wall, like the pieces of a puzzle or a child's uneven scrawl. Up a narrow flight of stairs in a narrow little room, as I lie upon my bed in the early evening gloom, impaled on my wall, my eyes can dimly see the pattern of my life and the puzzle that is me. From the moment of my birth to the instant of my death, there are patterns I must follow just as I must breathe each breath. Like a rat in a maze, the path before me lies, and the pattern never alters until the rat dies. On the wall where darkness fell, and it's fitting that it should, for in darkness I must dwell. Like the color of my skin, or the day that I grow, my life is made of patterns that can scarcely be controlled.
There are times when I'm singing one of Paul's songs that I feel the song is really very personal and probably shouldn't be sung by anyone other than the writer. But there are other songs that go beyond one person.
Hello, darkness, my old friend. Because a vision softly creeping left its seeds while I was sleeping, and the vision that was planted in my brain still remains within the sound of silence. In restless dreams I walked alone, narrow streets of cobblestone, neath the halo of a street lamp, I turned my collar to the golden damp. When my eyes were stabbed by the flash of a neon light, split the night and touched the sound of silence. And in the naked light I saw 10,000 people, maybe more. People talking without speaking, people hearing without listening, people writing songs that voices never share. And no one did cancer grows. Hear
my words that I might teach you. Take my arms that I might reach you. But my words, like silent raindrops, fell and echoed in the wells of silence. God they made, and the sign flashed its warning in the words that it was for me, and the sign said the words of the prophets are written on the subway wall, and gentlemen calls and whispered the sound of the sign.
It has been a pleasure appearing with these young people on the Kraft Music Hall's trio tonight. Next week, the Kraft Music Hall will star Bobby Darin with his guests, Bobby Gentry, George Kirby, and Bobby Brand. Good night, Mr. Garfunkel.
Good night, Miss Wilson.
Good night, Mrs. Simon.
Well, good night, Mr. Borger.
Good night, Miss Wilson.
Good night, everybody.
Wait a minute. We can't say good night.
Why not?
What does Simon say?
Good night.